Not much is known about the arcade version of Rise of the Robots, basically because it was never released. What I can tell you is that Rise of the Robots was originally developed for the Amiga, and promised so many advances in the world of 2D beat-em-ups, such as 100 frames of animation per character, advanced AI that we'd never seen before, and an amazing soundtrack by Brian May. Well, the AI is nothing like we've seen before, it's bloody awful. Some of the worst fighting game AI ever. The animation is more like 3 frames per move, 100 frames, yeah, what a load of shit. As for Brian May's soundtrack, well, most versions only feature a 5 second guitar loop from Brian, so while technically true, it's still BS. Anyway, being that the arcade game was made after the home systems, you'd expect Mirage Studios to have made this the ultimate version. Well, there are more characters, but it's still the same crappy game in every possible way. You'll be going home in a bag. Round 1. The 3DO port features the cinematic intros, but the FMV that accompanies them is quite grainy. In-game it's the same crap and yet another version that doesn't feature any in-game music or scrolling arenas. Two versions were released for the Amiga. First we have the AGA release. This one has pretty good sized character sprites and a nice use of colour, but still missing most of the FMV, music, and plays a little slower than the other ports. Oh, and just like the CDI, the stages don't scroll. The standard Amiga port is pretty much the same as the AGA version, but now with much worse colour. On the bright side, it does play a little faster than the AGA version. CDI is not known for having very good games, so it's fitting that Rise of the Robots was ported to this system. On the plus side, the FMV is pretty clean and there's an all new and much better intro theme. On the downside, however, the game plays just as poorly as every other version, plus the character sprites are pretty small. It's also impossible to pull off any special moves, yet it's entirely possible to kill enemies by just spamming the same kick attack. Add in the stages that don't scroll and no in-game music, and you have a dull gaming experience that's even duller than the mess it was based upon. Probably the most pretty of all the versions of Rise of the Robots, but yet again, it's still another version that has no in-game music and plays like crap. Actually, this is the disc version you're seeing here. The CD-ROM release contains the cinematic intros. The game itself is just the same though. Surprisingly, the Game Gear port features some of the video sequences. It also has background music and stages that scroll. The game also has another one-up over the other versions too, as it's possible to pull off a special move in this port. finally a version of Rise of the Robots that is kind of playable, but still rubbish. This Mega Drive version has a lot of the cinematics, plus some nice music used within levels. The game also plays better than the other versions so far, but that's not hard to do. Just like the SNES version coming up next, this port has more animation than most other ports, and you can actually turn your character around. Now this is more like it. The SNES version is actually the best one out there in terms of gameplay, and just like the Mega Drive version you just saw, this features more video footage than the Amiga or DOS HD disc version. In the SNES release, the characters have been given some extra weight to make them feel less floaty. This really helps with the gameplay, but still doesn't stop this one being the worst fighter on the system. Another odd feature about this port is that during the battle sections, the resolution changes to the SNES high resolution mode of 512x448. The only other game to use this mode for actual in-game graphics is Ranma Half. As far as Rise of the Robots is concerned though, this is a fantastic port. It also has some good tunes in it. And let's take a look at all those versions of Rise of the Robots running side by side. It's hard to say which one's the best because they're all pretty awful, but one of them's got to be better than all the rest. Which one is it?